So I guess I'll tell y'all a little bit about me. I'm an 80s baby. Any 80s babies out there tonight? That's what's up. Yeah, I'm an 80s baby. I was 83 pounds when I was born. It was a big ass baby, y'all. I was born with diabetes and titties. Ain't that some shit? My father told me it was like watching a horse being born. Yeah, because after 2 hours, I stood up and walked down to the cafeteria. And it was an emotional day for my family. It was a really emotional day for my family. You know, my mom, she was crying because her hoo-ha looked like Free Willy's blowhole. And my dad was crying because his wife's hoo-ha looked like Free Willy's blowhole. He just standing in front of the hole like, how am I supposed to fill this up? Ironically, that's what they was thinking about me down in the cafeteria. Shit. And you know what's fucked up, y'all? My name. My parents actually named me Henry Boney. Ain't that a fucked up name to give a fat kid? I can't get jiggy with no Disney-ass name like Henry Boney. I was talking to my pops about it. He was like, well, son, what would you rather your name be? I was like, easy, Alexander Hamilton. Shit, have any of y'all seen that play Hamilton? Yeah, Alexander Hamilton had bars, yo. And it was the greatest intro of all time. Think about it. How does a bastard, orphan, son of a whore and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean, a Providence impoverished in squalor, grow up to be a hero and a scholar, the $10 founding father without a father, got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter. By 14, they placed him in charge of a trading charter. And every day while slaves are being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside, he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, and barter. Then a hurricane came. Devastation reigned. My man saw his future dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain, and wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain. And the word got around. They said, this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education. Don't forget from whence you came. The world's gonna know your name. And what's his name, man? Alexander Hamilton. His name is Alexander Hamilton. And I just wish that was my name, you know what I'm saying? Just think about it. You're arguing with your lady. She starts snapping. Fuck you, nigga. Who the fuck you think you are? Bitch, I am Alexander Hamilton. Bitch, I am Alexander Hamilton. But alas, I can't do that. Cause my name is fucking Henry Boney. My name is fucking Henry Boney. And it rhymes with free baloney. Ain't that some shit, man? And why is it when you a big black guy, everybody like to give you a compliment by saying you look like a fat black rapper? Like, I got dressed today, I was walking out, my boy's like, hey, I see you. Looking like Biggie Smalls. It's not the look I was going for. Nigga, fuck you, shit. Another homie, I see you, looking like Rick Ross. Still not a compliment. And I'm convinced Rick Ross only lost weight because he got tired of people saying he looked like Henry Boney. Because it's not a compliment. It's not a compliment, man. And why can't I be Ruben Studdard? Shit. Why can't I be sorry for 2004? You know what I mean?